So now, I'm gonna go confront Dr. Kosak and his epic man beard. Teach him how we do shit in America. You know, if he didn't get the fact of how we do things in America from me killing all of his robots. Now, I didn't know about this until like the other day. I was playing around. Notice this. That was an E-Tank. Now that I'm into the Kosak stages, you know, I only had two E-Tanks that I played the entire first half of the game, man. And you're like, oh shit. Because the other Mega Man's, Mega Man 3, there was a lot of E-Tanks you could find. And I spent most of the end of the game not using E-Tanks, but still getting them, even though I didn't need them because I had maxed out E-Tanks. And then Mega Man 5, they go back to putting a lot of E-Tanks around, which I never really needed because the game's pretty easy. But in this game, the game is really fucking hard. And some of the bosses, like I've described to you, can just kill you for no reason, and you can't avoid it. So you think, okay, well, they have to... What are they thinking? Because you made it so hard, and then you took out all the E-Tanks. Well, apparently the guys who were designing the Kosak and the Wily... Spoilers! The Wily castles. They didn't get the memo that they were taking E-Tanks out of the game. Because there are E-Tanks all over the fucking place. So, I'm probably going to end up with, I don't know, 7 or 8 E-Tanks by the time I get to, you know, towards the end of the game. And I'm going to end up using a lot of them on the last couple of stages. But that's okay. Because, yeah, I didn't think that was going to work, but for the shot, see what happens. I hear that move is kind of glitchy, depending on where you use it. As you'd expect. It's basically like the, like some like Batman kind of move, where it slashes on the shit and you can climb up. Well, you've seen me use it earlier. I used it earlier, didn't I? Let's see. There's a little thing. I went the wrong way. Doing this a long way. You could do it faster, but fuck it. I'll do it the poor man's way. Way it was intended. I still have all my items, so I don't even give a fuck. All my items are charged. Now I gotta kill this asshole. Hopefully he doesn't kill me. There you go. Damn it. I was trying to slide. But I was hitting, you have to hit down the A to slide. So I was going down a ladder. My fault. So now, this is giant... I don't know. It kind of looks like a bug to me. And I have to hit him with a ring in his big glowing clitoris, I guess. The big vagina in the middle of his head is his weak spot. And he's dead already. That was the hardest boss fight ever. He hit me once. And that was because I'm stupid. So now, level 2! What does this crazy Russian have in for me next? Oh, there's lightning. Going up to the attic now, I guess. Very vertical oriented levels. Which, I mean, that's another thing. I mean, anybody has never been particularly good at vertical design levels. Unless, I don't know. Unless they're not really focused on them. Just put ladders with no obstacles. Because when you put obstacles, they're fucking annoying as shit. So, I'm refill my ring here because my ring is very useful. I'm going to be using it a lot later. I think. There's this guy. Oh, God. Damn it. I can't turn around. What kind of bullshit is that? You jump on, and you're completely like that. Okay. That's even... That's almost worse. Completely have no control over this animal. I am the worst pet owner ever. Okay, so what I'm gonna do is I think I'm gonna cheat. Use this balloon that I've never used yet. And I'm gonna just make a big leap at that. Oh. Oh. Oh, there we go. Crisis averted. Puzzle is over. So we can kill this guy. Oh, that's pathetic. Are you serious? You can't even kill that fucking bat. Go up there again. Do it again. Alright. So the claw is pretty cool. Seriously? These weapons are so fucking weak and underpowered. They're worthless. I don't know what's going on. It pisses me off. Yeah, take that, bitch. Fucking out-ingenuity your ass. I don't know why they made these guys take two hits. It's annoying. It's just to piss me off, I guess. Because they used to take only one hit, didn't they? Like, all the flying enemies used to take only one hit before. They weren't really as stylized as that, though. They didn't look that cool before in the first Mega Man games. They had the... Alright, do I want to go get it, or do I not want to go get it? I don't think I'm going to go get it. Because I've only got three. Three's totally... they still didn't fix it. I thought by now, in Mega Man's history, that they would have fixed the bug. Where, when you pause the game, if you're on a ladder, you get kicked off the ladder, and fall into oblivion, and die. But apparently they hadn't fixed it yet. But oh well, it doesn't really matter. Just worry about this fucking clamp of death. I don't know how it's automatic like that, but... I wanna go get it. Yeah, I'm gonna go get it. Look up there. Somebody had to draw that one sprite for him looking up. I mean, if you're playing Sonic the Hedgehog, he looks up all the time if you want to see the upside of the screen, because fucking levels are huge. Oh, I remember this guy. It's a room boss. It's basically like a big block room with little platforms. And it kind of reminds me of how you'd fight Sigma in the first Sigma battle for Mega Man X1, where you had to climb up the little thing, and he was constantly shooting at you, so you couldn't really attack him consistently and dodge all of his attacks at the same time. You kind of had to just take it for the team and put yourself in a spot where you wouldn't fall completely off the platform so you can land more hits. Because this boss is easy. I mean, look, he's one shot away from death, and I've taken hardly any damage. So it's more that I want to get this over as quickly as possible because I want to continue playing the game. More so than I need to dodge his attacks because otherwise I'll die first. So, yeah. But I kind of like it. It was a neat idea. It's kind of weird, but it was neat. Level 3. Now we're getting down to serious business. And the music changes. Now this I'm not a fan of. I don't think anyone is. Background is automatically scrolling. And I'm limited in my pace to... You know... The screen scrolling. So... And it's like... This isn't even... None of this is remotely challenging. And it's gonna stop whenever I have to climb ladders and shit. So it's not like... I'm not rushed for anything. I just take my time and think about how much better the rest of the game is going to be. Because this fucking sucks. Being slowed down. Because the whole thing was like, you get to go fast. They give you a dash attack. You know? I mean, most of this is all platforming. You can't really dash around on 1 foot wide platforms. But, you know, everybody has dreams. Plus, you can't even see what's coming at you, so... It's nothing to kind of... But I knew that guy was going to be here, so... Figured I'd meet him halfway. And now the screen stops, so I can climb up here. And actually do something that's remotely challenging. If you didn't know, you can kill those guys with the ring. I think you might be able to kill them with other stuff, too, but... I know you can definitely kill them with the ring. And now more slow scrolling that everyone's a huge fan of. I kind of like this. A little platforms, jump on them, and they go up. Yay. Kind of a neat mechanic. It never gets used ever again. Well, they kind of get used a little bit. They got those platforms that, the little, like scale platforms, Mega Man 6, where you jump on one, the other one goes up. Stuff like that. That's kind of neat. But beyond that, this is it. And it's not like there's anything in your way. You just jump across, and every now and then, there's a flying Saturn robot guy with eyeballs, and he takes one bullet to kill. I've never been able to figure out how to get that E-Tank, and I'm not going to worry about it now, so just keep going. Doesn't matter. I don't need it. I don't need it, man. I'm fine. I didn't need the other three or four E-Tanks I passed up because they were took too long to get, and they were too dangerous and not worth it. There's like a spider bot or something, I don't know. He's pretty easy to kill no matter what you do. All you have to do is dodge his shit and just keep wailing on him. You probably kill him with a regular buster, it wouldn't take so long. So you think, okay, second one comes out, he shoots a lot more shots, and oh, it's serious business, but it's not really, because, I mean, look, I'm just standing here, I'm not even doing anything, and he's not even coming close to hitting me. Look at this. How pathetic must you feel? I mean, I know how Kosak was like, hey, I'm the best robot designer in the world, and I'm gonna prove it. Well, if you're building fighting robots like that, maybe you're not the best robot builder in the world. Because that was just sad. What are you gonna defend with that? I don't know. Maybe if I was playing Contra, you'd be able to kill somebody, but sure as hell not killing Mega Man. I don't have that Mega for... I got that Mega in my name for a reason. So this looks like it's going to be a lot of dropping puzzles. And I need to refill my drills because I'm really, really going to need them. Like, really bad, girl. So... use my balloons, get the other one. Damn it. Hey, look at that. I fucking broke physics. Fuck you, physics. I'm Yoshi. Did anybody get that reference? I don't even remember what it was. And look, there's another E-Tank. Look at how many E-Tanks there are. I literally had like two when I started this dungeon. And now I'm up to five. And I'm almost done. Well, no, I'm not almost done. I forgot. There's a whole other fucking castle I gotta beat. I'm sure you knew that, though. So, I don't think there's a way to kill those electric guys that are guarding the platforms. They always have, like, one of those in one in every Mega Man game. I don't know how to beat it. So, I don't worry about it. Now, I usually take the other path. But, I want to see what's up with this path. I haven't been up this path in a while. Damn it. I'm trying to time it. God damn it. Fucking asshole. Alright, there we go. Yeah. This isn't so bad, is it? The life I'm not gonna need. Hopefully. Oh, do I need that? Why not? I wasted the time to change weapons that I might as well go get it. Good luck dodging that shit, fucker. Hate stuff like that. That's half of what this game is. And then, okay, that was just me. That was stupid. I could have dodged that. There you go. So I think this is the first real alternate path split in Mega Man history. Was, you know... Why? Why did you build it that way? What did you want me to do? That's why you put that there, so I can just get hit in the face and not feel guilty about it. Is that what it was? Fuck you, Inafune. I know you had something to do with it. I'm not even gonna bother with that fucking energy tank because it's pain in the ass aiming in that little slot and actually jumping up there. It usually hits your head and you get stuck. It's just stupid NES physics kind of crap. Oh, it's the final showdown against, between Mega Man and one of those fucking claw machines that you see in every entrance of all the Walmarts. That fucking has, like, Sonic the Hedgehog on it and shit. He's gonna try to grab a prize and then slam it against the floor really hard because he's mad that he didn't get the lobster flute. Oh shit, it's a Proto Man! And there's a girl with a hat. Totally Kosek's daughter. Kalinka. Now, this is what gets me. How the fuck did Wily have the ability to teleport? I thought that was only what robots could do. Even then, it doesn't really make sense. But Wily can teleport. He teleports there, right in front of fucking Mega Man. And, now he's escaped. He was right there. He didn't even have his ship with him. How did he get away? God, Mega Man must be retarded.